Okay, we have, the first item on the agenda is the minutes for the Tuesday, March 21 meeting. Has everybody reviewed the minutes?
Yeah.
Any changes or additions?
Look good.
Look good.
All right, I'll make a motion that we approve the minutes for March 21. I don't think do we have a second?
Yep.
All in favor?
Aye.
I don't think we've had a correction to the minutes in about a month now.
Lisa's doing outstanding.
Thank you, Lisa.
You're welcome.
Okay, meetings attended by select board members.
Busy week.
Where did we attend? See, we went to Berkshire East.
We all went to Berkshire East, yeah.
That was for the Franklin County Selectments Association.
Yeah. Perhaps not a selectman event, but Tuesday night there was Jeremy Rogers spoke at the Historical Society. So I went representing the selectmen, unofficially, but
okay.
And I can tell you, Jeremy gave an excellent talk.
I noticed that it was very crowded in there.
It was standing room only,
so.
and I think that his talk included things that nobody in the room knew. You know, and I think there were a lot of people that learned brand new things about the history of Conway, which was great.
Right.
And exactly what they went there for.
Okay.
On Wednesday.
And Wednesday, yeah.
Were all three of us, did you go to the Frontier budget?
No, I did not.
So we went to the Frontier budget hearing at Frontier, and that was good. And on Thursday, after the Franklin County quarterly Selectmen's Association, I went down to what's called the Small Town Summit, which is a meeting of sort of people representing small towns who all have common issues, and some of those got talked about in the meeting today.
Are you forgetting last night?
And Monday, go ahead.
Well, you want me to talk about
it? Sure.
Okay, we went to the Incident Command System 700 class at Turner's Falls High School. So now we're almost officially educated in incident management. Almost.
John and I each took the test and are certified with the 100 level.
You feel any better now?
Oh, yeah. Actually, it was interesting. So.
Okay. Yesterday, myself and the police chief met with the County Grammar School Committee and principal on what we call a school safety meeting, and what that was to entail was we set up a disaster plan for anything that could happen down the grammar school, like storm related or reunification of the students, or all that stuff was involved. And we were told that they're going to probably use Conway's plan as the guideline for the whole four communities, schools, and district.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah, it was good.
Good. I don't see any citizens here, so I guess we don't have any citizens' concerns. Okay, next item on the agenda is the fiscal 2018 budget and annual town meeting warrant.
The first thing I have is a request from the ambulance department for a warrant article for a bill from a prior year. This is a reimbursement for training for $451.30. I didn't think there would be much controversy about adding that as a warrant article.
Yeah.
Was that article already placed, Tom, or not?
I'm sorry?
Did we have a placement in there for that article already or not?
You know, I had one in there and I deleed it because I got it confused with a different.
Okay. So it's not back in
here?
From
the prior year. They had two, and so I would like to reinsert that.
We have one of those from the ambulance almost every year, so it's not a big deal.
It's not a transfer of funds or anything like that, it's just a...
I
think I heard that they have the money in the budget. It's just because it was spent out of a previous year that they have to have that.
The town meeting, yeah. Just a couple of notes as well. I have taken out the $29,000 request from Frontier for a capital project because the Frontier School Committee did not make a recommendation on that at their meeting. And so at the request of the superintendent, I have removed that from our budget.
Wow.
Apparently, they're going to be able to make a lower tier improvement to get them by until they study the issue a little bit more closely.
Really? So the 180-something thousand estimate they had to do something with the roof is no longer on the table?
No. There are both lower and higher estimates, and there's a certain amount of work that they can do to fix the immediate problem within their current budget.
Okay. Well, that's good.
And I don't see a need at this point. Article 18 I stuck in case we needed to spend some money for tornado relief, but I believe that our insurance is going to pay for the salt shed. And the other items we have both relate to the Fournier woods behind the salt shed. There is an immediate bit that I'm working to try to get cleaned up that's adjacent to the field. There are trees down, they're covering the trail and all that sort of thing. There is another section down, sort of in the middle of the woods, which is also covering the trail, but that is in endangered species habitat and will take more permitting to get done. That said, we can probably get, it is conceivable that we could get both of them done, and the overtime for the tornado within what we have available in our reserve fund. So I don't see at this point a need for additional funding for those things. The logging in the Conway State Forest, we don't have an estimate on, but we could do it a number of different ways. And if we actually wanted to take the logs out, it would be more expensive. If we just want to clear the trail and let the logs lie, let the trees lie, aside from being on the trail, that would be much less expensive. But it's going to take a machine to go in, apparently, and that's going to take extra permitting because it's in the endangered species area. So I'm not including that right now in my thoughts because it could go either way. It could be relatively inexpensive or it could be pretty expensive. So I believe we can fund everything we need to fund right now through our reserve fund.
You don't want to put in a not more than amount in there just to be safe?
I don't know what it would be. What we could, and we'll have to see. My latest estimate for what we have available, we have, I think, about 75,000 in excess levy capacity. Once you see how much we're spending and what it's going to do to us, you probably won't want to spend any extra money. And of course, we could authorize money but not spend it, but we do have to raise the money that we have authorized, even if we don't spend it. So it's an item to talk with the Finance Committee about.
All right.
I'll put it that way, because they control the reserve fund, and it's conceivable we could do transfers between accounts at the end of the year if we had to as well. So my bet is we can do it within this year's budget.
Okay.
So I wanted to mention those two things in particular. Also, you'll notice in Article 2, there's a clarification under item 900, employee costs. Our chair had asked that we show in the warrant what the distribution of costs is between the town and the Conway Grammar School on those items. And this is my attempt to present them in a way which doesn't make it look like we're adding them up. I should probably put the town and Conway Grammar School in italics too, just to emphasize that we're not spending, and they're not lined up as though they would be if we were adding them up. I was just a little concerned that we not do anything confusing.
Okay.
So this is how I've done it. Certainly open to suggestions for improving the presentation. And it still stays on one page, which is amazing. Otherwise, we're going to have serious words.
Well, just make the print smaller, Tom.
Oh, it's
it's pretty small.
Yes, it is.
But,
yes, it is.
I've got a chart with even smaller print to hand out later.
Oh, good.
All right, so that's what I had for. Yes, I'll have something else under sources and uses when we go over the money items with the finance committee. So I have a sheet on that. And if you cared to make any recommendations on the non-money articles now, that would be
okay.
Just
let's,
great.
Let's go over.
See, the first one is right at the beginning, and the non-binding referendum on going forward with the borrowing for the highway garage, Article 5. Is not a money item. It's just put there because it's right after the putting money into the garage stabilization account.
So this May that's talking about is a year from now.
Right.
Yes.
I asked to have that put in so that we could get the consensus of the townspeople if they want to start moving forward again with that. So
good idea.
Do you need a vote on that, Tom?
Yeah.
To recommend the article, yeah, we'll need votes on all of the articles.
All right, I'll make a motion that we recommend Article 5. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
3-0.
Okay.
A note on Article 6 as well. I believe this is still my current thinking on how to fund the 100. No, I will. There is a different breakdown of how to fund Article 6 that I'll pass out later when we're going over the money articles. Article 12 is just repurposing some money that we had already allocated to Frontier for their old facility, and they wanted that reallocated towards moving costs.
Right, for the movement of their central offices.
Yes, so that's also a non-money article.
So they want to use the remaining $17,930 toward moving purposes of repairs and roofing the central office?
Yeah, they have already obviously used some funds to do that.
Right.
We can always vote this, and then if they don't need it, that goes into their excess and deficiency fund, their free cash.
All right, so instead of repairs and re-roofing, they're going to use that as moving to Frontier Regional?
Yes.
Okay. Does that sound okay?
And they've already done that move.
Yes, they... So they would like this to help them defray the costs in this fiscal year.
Okay. How does that sound?
Yeah, fine with me.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we approve Article 12. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, 3-0.
And we will need to work with the Finance Committee on Article 13. Mm-hmm. Once we're done, you remember last year we spent a whole lot of money out of stabilization to fund their operating expenses?
Mm-hmm.
What that means is that there's now just barely enough to contribute to their operating expenses from the receipts reserved from this year. So I think there's only about $3,000 left after we appropriate the, there's the $15,000 in Article 2,
mm-hmm.
and then we appropriate more money in Article 14. I might change the order of those. What I'm thinking is that we can get rid of Article 13 entirely and just leave the $3,000 in their receipts reserved. Their stabilization fund has about $150,000 in it now.
Oh, all right. That sounds like...
So we might just get rid of 13 entirely, or it would be something like $3,000.
I'm just leaving a question mark now.
Yeah. Tornado community preservation. Repurposing. We'll go over that repurposing. Since that repurposing is town funds, Article 20, we'll probably go over that with the Finance Committee.
How about Article 17? Before we get there. We can vote on that, can we?
Raised appropriation $90,000. $90,000.
Or do we have to discuss that in Finance Committee first?
Yeah.
We better work again.
I'm sure the Finance Committee won't mind that.
Yeah. All right, we'll wait a minute.
And there's the right to farm. Oh, I've got to take that down to 11-point type.
And is it a law that we have to include it in the warrant, the entire?
I believe so.
Entire bylaw?
If we don't, we have to supply the language anyway. So it's either in the warrant or a separate piece of paper. The Agricultural Commission did recommend it 3-0.
Okay, and
did they have a hearing on it?
A lot of people spoke. It was actually relatively well attended, and they will have the changes. They will have a handout that shows the changes from the version presented at last year's town meeting, mm-hmm. and they'll talk about those changes.
It's really not something we need to recommend.
I can always write no recommendation.
What do we think on that?
That sounds pretty normal recommendation.
Yeah, they're really low. I don't mind recommending it, but it's okay.
What would you say about
it? I don't mind recommending it, but.
Okay.
I mean, I think they went back from last year and did a good job making changes to it.
Okay. Do you feel strongly about recommending it?
No.
Okay. All right. Then you're kind of toward neutral. And Bob, you're toward neutral.
I'll be happy if we have no recommendation and leave it to the town. Sure.
All right. Let's. I'll make a motion that we do a no recommendation for the agricultural
Second.
Article. All in favor?
Aye. Okay. It's not a no vote, it's just a vote on
it. There's three planning bylaws. The first two go together, but they're amending different sections of the protective bylaws, which made it a lot simpler to do as two different articles. The first one is changing the setbacks. So they're adding a great deal of clarification to this.
It was always 25 feet, wasn't it?
I'm sorry?
Wasn't it always 25 feet?
Well, this specifies a special permit process and the role of the zoning board of appeals and requirements for the applicant, which are all new.
They're adding in the accessory part of it, that's right there.
Yeah, it's, there's exceptions. Based on a special permit.
Yeah, I know, they've worked pretty hard on these.
I don't think we need to recommend them, do we?
I don't see that we do.
Okay.
So I'll make a motion that we have no recommendation.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
The next one is just definitions attached to the prior.
Okay. No recommendation. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
And the third one is the changes necessary in order for there to be some sort of congregate housing. Right now, Conway's bylaws only allow for duplexes on a single lot. This would allow for multiple units. This is what would have been necessary if the housing committee had moved forward with their plans.
Right.
So this is multiple units specifically for 55 years old and older?
Yes. Yes, as seen in the very end of the article, there are some definitions. Since this is part of the same proposed bylaw, I did not separate the definitions in this article.
Right.
But it talks about age restricted, an individual who is 55 years of age or older.
Now, this is important for us because of Law 40B that requires a certain amount of affordable housing in town. Mm-hmm. And I think we should put our recommendation on this. Okay. I'll make a motion that we recommend. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
And to on to the climate change resolution.
Article 25.
We probably should have backed this because we probably backed it with him when he was in presenting this.
Mm-hmm. I'm missing. Oh, 13 and 14 are reversed in my
page 13 and 14.
Yeah.
What do you think, Bob?
Yeah, I recommend it. We voted for it.
Yeah.
And
well, you voted that it be on the warrant.
We put it in here.
So now the question is do you recommend it to town meeting?
Content. You recommend the content, Robert.
You know I recommend the content.
Well, I know you do. That's why I asked. All right. Do you feel strongly we should recommend it?
I do.
Okay. Bob, what do you think? Okay. I'll make a recommendation that we recommend Article 25. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Is that a 3-0?
3-0. Yeah.
So soon the Energy Committee is going to be working with a Mass Power Forward, a state group that's working to help towns move towards 100% renewable energy, all carbon free.
Right.
And
right.
You know, encouraging towns to possibly aggregate with greener electricity for the whole town, and do things like they're doing, put in solar, insulate buildings, you know.
The Energy Committee's doing a great job.
And the Energy Committee's great, yeah.
Yeah, doing a great job.
And finally, the campaign finance reform resolution.
Okay, I'm glad we didn't call it the anti-corruption resolution.
Campaign finance, that's what it is.
Yeah. Since not every campaign contribution from a corporation is corrupt. Okay. Thoughts on 26?
Well, I support it.
Okay.
John, how about you?
I think it's important, yeah.
Okay.
I'll make a motion that we recommend Article 26.
Agreed.
Okay. All in favor?
I'm not going to sum it down.
Only 26 articles, Tom?
I'll see what I can do.
We must be slick.
No, I'm going to add the ambulance.
You remove one and add one.
Great. Perfect timing.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
You're home now, is it?
How many members are you expecting, Alan?
Majority of all present.
Majority of all present.
Wait.
Good cover us to have two others at least.
Okay, all right, we'll.
That's good cover.
Would you like that?
All right, Tom, next item on the agenda is the FERCOG IT grant for the Community Compact. Request for town sponsorship.
Yes, this request by the FERCOG has been withdrawn. They're going to be working with another town.
Oh, right.
To do this.
So we're just going to withdraw that? Okay.
Yeah, if you want to see what it's about, you have the information included in your packet.
So is this the second round of IT work?
Through the Community Compact, yeah. You can see that in the information provided.
New Salem that stepped in?
Okay.
All right, well, while Finance is waiting for their next two members, do we have anything non-anticipated in 48 hours before the meeting?
I do not have any.
Okay. Do you have your update, Tom?
I do not have an update.
Okay.
Busy doing that.
Busy since the last meeting, yes.
All right. Do you have any concerns with the selectmen?
None here.
None?
I'll make a little bit of announcement when we get this.
Okay.
Well, there is an announcement. Oh, you've got an announcement.
You have an announcement?
Yes.
What is it?
Okay.
Well, I went down to grammar school today. I haven't noticed there's a big excavator private side of the salt shed. So Ron was there loading the trucks. I stopped beside Ron. And they delivered the Springfield Albert, delivered this big excavator, start taking the roof off the salt shed tomorrow.
Yeah, but you know what I mean?
Maya has approved this company to come in and take it. Ron said, take it off and put the roof back on, and we have a good deal with any of it.
You know, I would have put that in my update if I had 30 seconds to think.
All right.
So
when will that be done?
The home will have it off by Thursday. Told it off by Thursday and start working on whenever they put the roof back on.
Mm. Great.
It was a bit of a runaround to get all the approvals from everybody to move forward with that. But
I think that's a good idea. We don't have to deal with a bid or nothing.
We got everything straightened out. Yes, Maya does a great job in taking care of us.
That's great. And saves them money.
Yes, it does.
Oh, yeah.
So the same company with that excavator right there is going to take it off
and put
the new one back on.
Great.
That's your rental.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good thing.
Okay.
Mail. And Ron took the incident command course 100 and 702.
Yes.
Right there.
I got a letter from Lee Totman, and it was a complimentary letter about the article that was in the Recorder a couple of Saturdays ago.
Okay.
So, and that was very nice of him to take the time to do that.
Which article is that? The one that you wrote, or
the one that you, my turn?
Yeah.
Okay. Is there anything in that? Anything else, Bob? In that purple? I think the purple folder might have a thing or two in it.
Oh, let me see what we got here.
All right, we got the latest from MMA on their House and Senate drafting fiscal 2018 budget bills. I think everybody probably got an email about this. We received information from Division of Fisheries and Wildlife pertaining to a draft priority habitat map map for public comment beginning on April the 3rd. Did we get that map, Tom? Or, oh, it's good. It's online.
Yeah.
You can access it online. There was some information that I had asked Jan to separate out on the budget that we'll talk about with finance.
So is that the split in the employee costs?
That's part of
Article 2?
That's part of it, yeah.
Yeah.
There's a Hampshire Select Boards Association invitation to their Thursday, March 17 meeting at the Blue Bonnet Diner. That's this Thursday.
Oh, geez.
It's this Thursday. It's 2 days from
March. We're going to be over.
I've got a FERCOG Finance Committee meeting.
What was the date on that? The 30th?
I can't go. That's the 30th at 5:30 at the Blue Bonnet Diner. We went to one not too long ago. It was very good meeting.
FERCOG has scheduled a climate change conference that night.
I saw that. So,
right.
So I'm planning on going to that.
Okay. Bob, you want to see that?
No.
Okay.
No way.
Something for the school.
Do we meet?
Run. The Conway Grammar School's run.
Is it in here?
Yeah. That's the one.
We got an email from the Conway Grammar School. They're going to have a 5K run on Sunday the 21st, starting at the ball field. I'm sure we're going to get plenty of information on that between now and the 21st of May. So
I expect quite a few people, they said. Pressure runs
out. Yeah. Is this the first time they're doing this?
No, they had it last year, I think. I think they only had it on Warren Book Road, if I remember correctly. Warren Book, I think. No, wait a minute. I'm wrong about that. I think it was up along the cover bridge last year.
All right, and
I think that's probably the same.
Our police chief knows about it, and our highway super knows about it.
Yeah.
And I'm, as I say, I'm sure we're going to have much more information on it before then.
Yeah.
But the date is May 21st. Maybe we can run as a team.
So we'll all run together?
Yeah.
At least run 1K?
Yeah. Right.
Can we tag team it?
Probably the best thing to do.
0.5K.
Yeah, 0.5. Right. Yeah. Right. Okay, and you already talked about it. Okay, we're looking good here with the Finance Committee, so we can...
You said it was on the 21st?
May 21st.
No gym today.
9 o'clock in the morning.
Are you fixed? Is that covered?
I think not.
You're committed. I'm worried tonight.
So we can't vote?
No, we can't.
Yeah, you got three.
You guys have one more coming?
I don't know. Yeah, right.
Supposedly.
I thought he was.
Bob, you come over here and we'll vote. You're missing two, right?
I just gave you a copy of this.
You're right.
May have to be a majority amongst all of us. Yeah.
Well, I tried to make it.
You gave me one.
Oh, I did.
Oh, you know, there's one other thing I want to mention, too, before we go on to finance.
We keep getting these brand new things.
Oh boy, huh?
Yeah. Sorry about the
collectible.
See, they're really good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got one. Yes. All right.
Okay. Yeah.
Before we start with finance, a we forgot to mention a meeting under meetings of the select board this morning.
Oh, yes.
We had a meeting that was sponsored by Senator Hines. We had 15 state senators here listening to people in the community, community leaders in various sections of the community, talking about some of the challenges and opportunities that rural communities face. So we had, roughly 80 people, okay, upstairs. And unfortunately, we were supposed to have that meeting was originally scheduled, that gathering was originally scheduled for the church. And it was set, obviously, before the tornado. And then we moved it into this room. And we found out late last night that we would probably have many more people than would fit in this room. So we had to move it upstairs. Unfortunately, we don't have wheelchair accessibility to get upstairs. So we had to turn away two town residents because of that. That was very unfortunate. It was solely my decision to do that. It was not a, you know, not a happy decision, but based on the fact that we could not fit all those people in this room who were here, we had to do that. So I wrote one of those residents who could not attend because we couldn't get him upstairs, a letter of apology that went in his mailbox this afternoon. And hopefully he accepts that apology. Okay, on to...
Where is that meeting? Was that videotaped? Or
Yes, it was. It's on FCAT now.
Should
it's
be up on FCAT now.
Right now.
How long is it?
Chris Collins videotaped it, and he edited it, got it right online. Before we start on our budget situation, I spent some time looking over the Conway Grammar School budget over the weekend and noticed some things that we should change for the future. If you notice on Article 2 under 900, I wanted it broken out because we just have it under employee costs, and I wanted it to be broken out in terms of what town employees cost and what school employees cost.
Yep.
And I handed out this sheet of our medical insurance expenses. And if you look at those annual premiums at the far right-hand column, it kind of knocks your eyes out. And if you go down further on that page, you'll see the number of our town employees that have what plans they have and the number of school employees and the ratio of the expense for the town to the school. It's about 22% for the town and about 78% for the school. I also noticed that, that insurance expense is nowhere on the budget for Conway Grammar School. It is basically on our side of the budget.
Yeah, been away for...
Yeah.
So essentially,
Eduardo,
if you look at that second page, if we count their insurance increases, their budget didn't go up 2.9%, it went up almost 6%, about 5.74%. And that's after they reduced their budget. So we really need to keep a sharp eye on the school budgets, because it's just causing a tremendous amount of...
So, John?
Yeah.
Can I interrupt for a minute?
Yeah, just let me finish this page. And you also see here the OPEB, the other post-employment benefits. Again, our town share is about 22%, and the school share is about 78%, or $938,000.
Yeah.
And they have done nothing in terms of trying to fund that liability. So we have to look for them to do that.
That was one of the orders, and we had an order from Roselli Clark, that was one of the MD&A section of the letter from the auditor to the select board, was that there should be, in the future, a line item for OPEB for the school. There is one for town, obviously.
Right, yeah. Roy, what do you have?
Well, so let me address again my feelings about OPEB. I still don't understand why one needs to get more than even 1 year ahead on this thing. This is something that we fund out of pocket, and we've done it forever. I don't mean out of pocket. I mean as it's assessed, right? So granted, the Wall Street or the state or whoever's asking us to get way ahead of the curve with this, and I just don't see how it's possible.
The OPEB calculations are based on worst case situations. So the number that you see is a huge number, okay? But they're concerned about the fact that there may be unfunded retirement benefits, and that's the reason that it's, you know, it's a worst case scenario.
And just a little bit of history. This became a much bigger deal after the Great Recession. There were a number of larger municipalities that lost a great deal of money in their pension funds, and they ran into immediate problems with their pensions. Small towns are not in that situation, but the laws that were written were one size fits all. And so the fiscal tightness that the auditors are looking for in order to show that your community is going to be solvent in the long run were put on small towns just the same as they were on larger towns. Now we're going to be required to report our OPEB liability and to bring it onto our balance sheet as we go forward. They're ratcheting up the amount that we're going to have to pay attention to it. And most small towns feel that this money is better spent on current needs rather than locking it away and not being able to use it. The larger the municipality, the more likely they are to pay more attention to it because their liability is much greater, and their exposure to what happens in the financial markets is much greater. So, which is what led to the pension fund collapse of a decade ago.
Well, thanks for sharing the background to this, but still, I think that I think it's going to cripple towns, is what I think. It contributes to the financial crippling. We've got enough problem now. You go there. It's almost like through my travels, there is a wall. It's literally a wall somewhere east of Worcester. That is a whole different world there in many, 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 many. Many ways. And if our legislators, and I'm very sorry I missed this meeting because I have no idea what transpired, but our legislature needs to be much more cognizant of this, in my opinion, that they do not, you know, over here, real estate is graded as fairly valued. You get towards Boston and into Boston, there's a massive amount of speculation, of restricted land usage that gets factored into the equation. And this blows the whole thing up. It blows it up compared to us. And so I think that, and I'm happy to express myself to whatever the legislature. I don't want to take a lot of time.
If you look at the economy inside the 495 corridor, as compared to the economy out here, it's day and night.
Correct.
Day and night.
Yeah, correct. So, getting back to the grammar school, I just want to make sure. So you added, you took last year's insurance and added, and compared to, I mean, the current year, you added it to the, because they've never, included the cost of the insurance in their operating budget.
So, well, that's because it was on our side of the budget under employees.
Right.
Yeah. But,
to get to the 5.74, you did it this year, and you did it and in the budget we're talking about as well.
Yes, the calculations are right down the bottom of the first sheet.
Yeah, so I'm saying fiscal year 17, that's this year, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so 1792, so 184.
Yeah, if you look at the first sheet on the bottom.
Of this sheet,
right? Yeah. No, this sheet.
This sheet.
Now, I just broke that out so that people can see the difference between, because Their increases were hiding in our budget, on our side of the budget, basically.
Right. Right.
So I wanted it broken out so that people can see that it's, you know, the expense here.
If we did this with Frontier, what would that 10%
Yeah, but you see, Frontier has a line item for insurance.
Okay.
But the Conway Grammar School doesn't because it was on our side of the budget.
Yes.
And the reason why it wasn't noticed for a number of years was because the insurance premiums for the Hampshire Insurance Trust didn't go up for 4 years in a row.
Right.
No, it's been.
Okay.
It's been noticed, John. This 15 years ago. The budget's actually more than it is because the health isn't part of it.
Okay. So my point is,
we need to break that out, and they need to consider that in their budget when they hand it to us, because if they're not, then it's crippling our side of the budget.
Yeah.
And what we can do.
So we are comparing apples to apples.
Yes, we are with the
proposed budget.
Absolutely. Yeah.
I'm going to add with regard to OPEB. Well, thank you for doing this, John. The if we go to bond in the future of our money, how we're evaluated will also be how we handle this. So if we do keep a line item in our budget for including covering Conway Grammar, that would put us and a higher level performing financially, so that would lower our borrowing costs.
We have to show that we're making some effort to reduce that liability. It doesn't have to be 100% payout, but we have to make some effort to show that we're trying to reduce that.
Do we have a line item for Frontier in our budget now?
Do we what?
The line item would cover OPEB for Frontier Regional.
So is that just included in the Frontier costs?
This is just Conway Grammar.
But so when it says Frontier Regional Operating, that do they have something for OPEB?
Yeah. But getting back to this, this is on a lot of this from the Conway Grammar School is under collective bargaining. So, I mean, we're contractually bound. I mean, so it's real.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
It's real.
You know, we need to find out who's negotiating our contracts with.
This is a question I had as well, because I understand. So we still got 2 years to go on this contract, which means the negotiations typically will start after this coming year,
right?
A year before. Right. So who does the negotiating on our behalf?
Well, that's a good question. We need to find that out. Mm-hmm.
There's a team that's made up of people from each town. It's led by the lawyer that the administration hires. It's a firm out of Springfield, and they, I was part of it this year.
You talk about the school district?
Yeah.
Hires this, okay.
Yeah, and the superintendent worked closely with the principals and the lawyer to come up with a list of administration proposals. The teachers through the Mass Teachers Association come forward with their proposals. The usual negotiations took, 4 or 5 sessions typically. And there's both the teachers negotiation and the instructional assistants negotiation. They happen concurrently but separately. And again, representatives from every town. A lot of people brought a lot of issues to the table, and we got what we got. The superintendent did get
more or less what she wanted. She had a maximum increase over 3 years and was able to have the first year be a lower percentage rise so that it was a lower basis for the next 2 years going forward. Massachusetts Teachers Association typically comes in with a request for 3%, 3%, 3% each year for 3 years as a base salary rise over which there are steps. So the distance between those is what's at stake.
And the future will be, I would appreciate maybe the whoever can compile these figures would break out their actuarial assumptions for this. That would be helpful for me to understand the time horizon. You know, is it 25 years, is it longer? I mean, that would be really helpful to figure out how they come up with this, this basically unfunded liability. It's all finance stuff. It's basically taking the liability and taking the present value of it.
For the record, I would like to state, at least it's my understanding, and this is going to go nowhere because we're not negotiating anytime soon, but having attended several of the school budget hearings this year, the common refrain is, you know, the charter schools, they suck all this money out, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. I do want to state that, it's my understanding anyway, that the pay scale at the charter schools is considerably lower than the pay scale in our Union 38 district. And everybody needs to sort of look at that and I think dwell on it, because it's not like, I don't know if they have trouble finding teachers or if they don't have trouble finding teachers. I can't attest to the quality of the teachers that go to the charter schools versus the non-charter schools, but there's a tendency to want to throw money at education, and I think that that works up to a point, and I think that we can look at the charter schools and sort of try and find that point.
I agree. Tom, you want to go over the financial article?
Yeah, first I wanted to check in with your progress on going through Article 2.
I think all our recommendations are complete for Article 2.
Not complete.
No? What's outstanding?
Those stuff I sent in the minutes.
Article 2?
Oh, Article 2. I'm
Article
sorry.
2 is the main.
Yes,
first sorry. Page.
Sorry about
that. Schools and the town hall.
Right.
Other than the COLA, it doesn't look like.
Right.
Yeah, we wanted to see what the final COLA percentage was.
You did. Okay.
Have you recommended all these articles in Article 2? The way they're printed. Are you people aware of some of the pay raises that are in here?
What's the
final COLA?
No, we split them.
You have the final COLA, but the final cost of living adjustment. Yeah. That's you have the final cost of living adjustment for the budget proposed for FY18.
Well, a 2.5% increase would be $15,036. Right. 2%, $12,024.
I don't think we've made a successful vote on the wage adjustment as of yet. Mm-hmm. So. The last time we attempted it, we split two and two in two different votes. So,
well, what's your recommendation? Or what's your range of recommendation?
I would have to make a motion for the committee, or I'd be seeking a motion for a number, and we can vote on it.
It's
right
it's
here.
$3,000 for every 0.5%. Right.
So. Does anyone feel the urge to throw a number out there?
2.5%.
Yeah.
All right. Do I get a second?
Second.
All right. All in favor?
Yep. Aye.
So your recommendation is
2.5%.
Are you there too?
All right. We'll go for it too.
What was the vote on that?
It looks like it's unanimous, I think.
Yes.
I don't know.
Oh, okay. 2.5% cost of living adjustment.
Well,
Like I said, a year ago, though, John, that you're saying, well, the town, but you don't want to be stingy, you know, given the cost of living, but I did say that there's way more people over 65 in this town than there's kids going to the elementary school. Last year, the cost of living was zero increase.
I mean, this Social Security.
For Social Security. Mm-hmm. This year, it's like 0.3. So X amount of the town is being asked to fund what they're not getting themselves.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, at a certain point, it kind of, it's hard to do.
I don't see how we can be out of step with the union.
That's what I mean.
Grammar school.
Every choice is like, well, what the hell
grammar school is in a collective bargaining.
That's right. Well, I think it's, I mean, who are we penalizing? These are our friends and our neighbors, and I don't see, this is not, I mean, it's good to discuss it, but I would rather, I think our effort, these other areas are gigantic compared to the 3,000 every quarter percent.
Yeah.
And so I don't see a point in demoralizing people and making them think that we think less of them.
Well, that's why the vote was 4-0.
Right.
Okay. Right. So the unanimous vote.
The issue is still there.
But I want to ask Bob Baker here, which specific increases were you referring to?
Well, okay. Let's get past that. All right. You're recommending unanimously 2.5%. Any discussion on that recommendation? I'll make a motion that we go for 2.5%. So I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
2.5%, Tom.
Yeah.
Okay, Roy, you have a question?
So I'm asking Bob, what specifically, which increases was he?
Well, first on, I don't want to seem like a bad villain, it's the town clerk.
Well,
Tom can add something to that. Tom?
Well, there's a discussion of it in the budget. I can't really add anything to the discussion that's in the budget.
How did we get to that?
This brings the town clerk up to the benchmark level that of fiscal year 16 mm-hmm. that we had identified. And that's the kind of middle point of all of the comparable towns that were identified and surveyed as part of the human resources study we had done just a couple of years ago. And this is the second of two planned increases. This was mentioned last year. It's actually slightly less than what was proposed as the increase to this year. It brings it up again to the to the benchmark salary of the peer group. That's the basic.
Is that a benchmark of the county survey?
That was the benchmark of the survey that was done by Don Jacobs that we're part of. So that's and again, my goal here is to bring it up to that sort of more reasonable level so that the next person who takes the job is likely to be able to keep it and have it. It is about a 30-hour-a-week position, depending on whether there's a national election that year or if there's a special town meeting or all of that sort of thing. So it can vary from lower in the 20s to above 30. It's been about 30 over the past year. Of course, this has been a national election year, but that's what the position is, and that's how we arrived at the figure.
Yeah. What was her prior rate? What was she at this year?
$1,500 more.
How much?
$5,800 more. Right.
Sure. Okay. Hourly wage. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, she is relative to her peers.
One of my concerns there is the availability to the town citizens.
Yes, she is available by appointment. I did survey the small town administrator's membership, and that's a common feature. Relatively few, I think only a couple out of 12 or 13 respondents had evening hours. A bunch of them had tried it, as ours did some time ago, and found that it wasn't particularly
How many hours a week are they available in their office? Is it rural over the county average? Is it in line with ours?
I didn't ask that question. But again, our town clerk is available by appointment and does see people when she's working over here at the Board of Health and stops them on the street. And,
okay.
So she's flexible in her availability.
My one final question on that one is, if you're going to allow that, are you going to allow that to be increased by 2.5% on top of it?
No. No, that's not slated for the 2.5% increase.
It's a salary.
It will be a new salary.
In that
concept. Yeah.
Okay, I think that's an important.
Yeah.
That's important to note because I've heard grumblings in the past that people didn't get their increase for whatever reason, and so we don't want there to be a grumbling this year that
they didn't get the percentage.
They didn't get their 2.5%.
Right.
No, you got your 28, 30, whatever the heck percent this is, right? And that's what you're getting, and go looking for the 2.5 on top of that, right? So, yeah. You know.
Part of that entire human resources study we did was to make sure that if we have people leaving positions, we can basically bring people into that position because especially, in small towns like this, we need to be able to hire people who can do the job, and that was one of the reasons for that whole human relations study and the compensation survey.
And of course, the town did decline to make it an appointed position. So, as an elected official, the town clerk can set whatever hours she or he likes.
That's the sad part.
And. It's interesting that the town clerk herself was in favor of making it an appointed position, but it failed at the ballot box after having passed the town meeting.
The town clerk's position is getting to be a very important position because of state-mandated regulations and requirements of that position. And unfortunately, the vote went against appointing a town clerk. That most towns are going toward an appointed town clerk now because it's better to go out and find someone that has the skills for the position rather than electing someone to the position who may not have those skills. So that was the reason why we had that on the warrant last year, and unfortunately it was defeated. So.
And you're aware that you're hiring an assistant for her too, right?
Well, that's my understanding is it's not permanent. That's an assistant.
Understudy, the trainee.
She's training.
That was a transition.
The clerk is currently in her first year of a 3-year term. Come July, it will be the second year, and she has indicated that she would consider retiring at the end of this term. We don't know that we can get somebody for this money. We don't know that person would be the next elected town clerk, but it is certainly better that more than one person know where things are and how things are done.
So there's a possibility that we won't have a retirement and we'll have a trained assistant?
I would never make any definite statement about the future.
So can we, when we hire that assistant or that trainee, whoever it's going to be, can it be with a clear understanding that it's a temporary position to become?
That's certainly the intention.
It has to be.
Yes.
Yeah, it's basically for overlap for that town clerk position.
Right, but what if...
And, Ginny has been the town clerk for, 30 years?
Yeah.
35.
So 35, there's a lot of knowledge there that someone has to pick up before, they could take over that spot.
Well, I guess I'm saying that if she decides to stay on another year, given that she's working at a better salary or whatever, can we have a plan in place where we can, without hassle, you know, not have the trainee continue it because there isn't enough work for that.
Well, we know how much it costs, so we cannot not recommend funding it, and the select board can not put it on the warrant.
That would be a decision we'd make next year at this time.
Next year?
Yeah.
Yep. So she'd be there for a full year? For a,
for what? What is it, 10
she'd
hours?
She'd be there for no. 2 years. Let's see.
Is the plan that the assistant would overlap with the newly elected clerk?
That's what I'm wondering.
Right. The person would be the assistant.
Would become the clerk.
Right. So it's kind of like I understood it to be like maybe a 6 month kind of in-house training. And
yeah.
It's more than six months.
It's $4,000 in.
Yeah. But we don't know if he'll run for election or not.
$4,000 for 1 year, the position.
Oh, 1 year?
1 year, $4,000.
Because it's very part-time.
It is very part-time, yes.
This is a little tricky. How do you do this?
That's 5 hours per week. 5 hours per week at the rate of $15 per hour. Again, this is meant to provide an opportunity for a town resident to become familiar with the requirements of the position in preparation for running for that office. I would actually recommend, I'll say right now, I would recommend that for the first year of the new town clerk's term, that we flip the positions and give the old town clerk the 5 hours a week at $15 an hour to act as a consultant for the first year that the other person is in charge. I think it is an extremely important position, and we want it to be a very smooth handoff.
Mm-hmm. Yep, that's a good idea.
That's down the road 2 years.
We had a question last week. So the highway department has an assistant, the town clerk has an assistant, which is temporary, then we have the town administrator position has an assistant. One question we had, are there any other assistant positions that might be in plan for the town?
The fire department has one, only for 1 hour a week.
All right, but any other assistant positions? That's one thing we're thinking of.
The assessor has an assistant.
Yeah. Okay.
The assessor's clerk.
Uh-huh.
That's Laura.
Okay.
Yeah.
But are we fully fleshed out with assistants?
Yes.
I don't see any more on the horizon.
You know, one thing that has happened with all our departments over the last 5 years or so is that the reporting requirements to the state have increased significantly. And that's one of the reasons why there's this need for more administrative help.
Yeah. Well, so the select board, you know, the whole select board, you know, the towns all together, the group, is there any kind of organized rebellion with the state? You know, it's kind of like you towns, okay, keep hiring all these assistants and this and that, because the volunteer positions can no longer keep up with all these rules and regulations and everything we're throwing at you. And it's kind of like, well, why are you doing this?
Well, you know, there was some talk about that this morning at the meeting about the public records law. And the new requirements for the public records law.
It doesn't hold to the legislature.
Well, you know, unfortunately, our legislative delegation here in Western Massachusetts only accounts for 11% of the votes
sure.
in the legislature.
Sure.
So.
But I mean, the open meeting laws don't pertain to the legislature.
I'm talking about the public. Did I say open meeting?
The public records law.
Right. It has become a burden on small towns. And it's not something that affects the bigger cities because they have staff, but it affects the smaller towns. And
just kind of like Tom said earlier about the OPEB stuff, the rules are kind of geared towards the big towns, and
yes.
maybe not too different than the education reform passed in the early 90s.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, that's what I'm getting at. So you just keep getting this stuff, isn't it?
Oh, we did leave out the Board of Health clerk as well. Mm-hmm. I will note that the town of Deerfield has an assistant
in the town administrator's office that functions as a clerk to all of the various boards. So they've consolidated that into one position, which I believe is still part-time. But that's another way of approaching it, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But so far we've done it more individually.
Yeah.
Just while we're talking on that clerk for the Board of Health, you are aware that they have put in the position the 2% pay raise for themselves already?
They typically do.
So
you're managing all of this.
When you do your calculations, you're going to have to calculate that one differently.
Yep.
So they built themselves. They
built themselves in.
It's hard to follow those instructions.
Well, it is. It's easy to slip up. You know what I mean? We asked all the department heads, right, that they level fund the salaries and wages.
Yeah, it's been that way for I think 3 years now.
And some of them reluctantly like to throw their own in.
Well, they're just trying to make sure we're on the ball. So Bob, what other salaries stood out?
The highway one. And this may just be a simple slide of the accounts. Do you know, Tom, on the highway one, the salaries, does that include the administrative assistant to the highway superintendent in the salary range? Or is she listed under the hourly wages?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, she is.
Which item is she listed under?
Highway salary and wages.
Well, there's two separate line items here.
422, the second.
I'm looking at this one that you gave us. They list them separate. I just wondered, because one went up $8,000 and the other went up $1,165. The two different categories.
Yes, the hourly went up $1,165. That was mostly
no,
in
the
order.
The salary one.
Wages. Wages went up $1,120. Should have been
$1,165.
I'm sorry, this isn't even 11. That's mostly for the foreman position.
Dollar an hour.
That's mostly to pay the foreman the extra dollar
be.
An hour.
Because the foreman pay would be $2,080, not $1,165. Because it's 2,080 hours in a year. At a dollar an hour, that was $2,065.
Questions about this.
So my question here is, I just want to know, this may be all right, this figure. I just want to know how they categorize.
So we're talking about line 422, the wages.
Yeah, right.
$9,139. Are we on the same version of this sheet?
Why is it in italics? Is there some reason why that number is in italics?
Because it's not finalized yet. That's without the COLA.
Okay. Well, none of the other ones are in italics.
Well, the other ones have... there's a figure, there's a rise that's built in because of the added foreman cost. Are there added...
So the foreman getting a dollar an hour and a 2% increase? Or
let me ask you this.
We don't have a foreman.
Let me ask you this, Tom.
Yeah.
Is the administrative assistant to the highway superintendent in fiscal year 2017's budget? Or is that not going to be start until fiscal year 2018?
No, it's in 17.
I think we shifted
it
that
is in
last
the 17
year.
Budget, yeah.
So where did the $9,139 come from then? If there's no wage increases added to that yet.
The laborer is slated to be $16 per hour. That's another rise in that. That's up from 10.
So that's increase for the new employee that you're gonna be hiring yourself.
Yes. Okay. With the hope of being able to retain them more than a few days.
So that must be the majority of that $8,000 then?
Yeah, that's from $10 to $16 per hour, so that's a lot. Mm-hmm.
What does that do to the surrounding health, labor?
Well, something doesn't add up here, folks. If you just said that, that's $12,000 a year increase. And he's only asking for $9,600.
Well, how many hours a week position is that?
40.
The labor.
The labor's 40.
So you're saying 2080 times $6? Is that how you're coming up with 12,000? Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't add up.
It wasn't 10 to 16. I think it was 12 to 16.
Oh, 12 to 16.
Yeah, it was probably it was 12 to 16.
Sorry.
Yeah.
So that's the $8,024 is for the...
The $4 increase.
$4 increase, yes. For the...
The labor.
Worker.
Yeah.
So the other 1165 must be some sort of digestion between the 2080 for the foreman and the difference of 1165, probably. I'm guessing. How
yeah.
He did that, I don't know.
Yeah.
Because you thought he would want to increase that $2,080 if you're going to put in the full-time position of without an hour more. No, I'm not cursing, but maybe this, now that these are all added up, he may be changing himself in that line item.
But that's not what you were trying to do. You were trying to question my
question. No, I wanted clarification. I wanted clarification because it didn't happen.
That's okay, yeah.
How many is on the crew?
There is three right now on the supervisor, and there's going to be back to four.
So Ronnie, there's four people on the crew.
Yes. Right now.
Mm-hmm. We're one short.
One short.
Mm-hmm. Five on the crew. Oh. I'm just wondering, if you got the highway boss and you got a five-man crew, what's the need for a foreman? It's only four guys.
It's very important. I'm going to tell you, and I'm going to defend this foreman position. Whoever gets it, I don't care. I'll defend it to the ground, because there's a lot of time in the course of the day, not in the course of a year, that the highway superintendent is not working with the guys out in the field.
Yeah.
Because of meetings, maybe in town or out of town, or out dealing with Mass Highway or something like that. And there should be some supervisor responsible for the rest of the employees.
So we're short a person since when? For how long?
Well, we tried to hire one. How many times, John, this year?
It's got to be what?
Three?
4 months? Eight. 5 months?
We lost someone back in the fall, and went through a hiring process, got somebody on board, and then lost, That person didn't accept the position. We went through another hiring process, hired somebody who left pretty much immediately upon being hired. And that was just a couple of months ago.
And you know, for us, we just can't go out and say, oh yeah, you want the job?
Right.
We've got to go through this whole hiring process. Right. We have to advertise, we have to, you know.
So how have we been functioning with a lot of overtime? Is that?
No overtime.
Yeah. We don't see any difference.
Not during the regular work week, but in snow removal business, they've had to work more overtime every day.
Yeah. You know, Ron had told us that the crew is working very well, and he felt he could get through the winter without that extra person, by bringing in a couple of contractors when we had to do some plowing.
So
which never took place.
Yeah, and we never did that, actually.
So we're talking about bringing on a laborer position at 16 and promoting somebody to the foreman?
Is it,
yes.
Tom, how is it worded in the new advertisement? Is it for a CDL license operator?
Yes.
So, yeah. So it's actually going to be a truck driver, laborer.
Okay. And we're hoping to get a better class of applicants for that.
Because your other class was very limited because of the...
I have heard this is not a problem just with Conway.
Of course not.
It is a problem across the board.
Look in your job description, the recording. You can see it almost every time there's an opening in somewhere.
Okay. Yeah.
That's all my questions, gentlemen. Thank you.
Okay, what's your recommendation on Article 2?
I think we've completed our recommendation.
Yeah,
we've voted it all up.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's recommended.
So you're satisfied with this latest version of the title?
Yeah, with whatever the school numbers actually work out to be, if there's small changes. The technical school, is that a final number on 320?
We're actually going to be hearing from the superintendent and the chair of the board of trustees in 2 weeks at the select board meeting, which is, I think, when we're going to be signing the warrant. But we do have their final numbers, yes.
All right, let's go on to the money warrant.
I mean, when you get down to an Article 2 and the Finance Committee, it is, once the state's done, you're only talking about the nickels and dimes. And on the whole Article 2,
yeah,
for the most part.
Yeah, yeah.
So yeah, if you want to stop on some employees, that's what you're left with.
Six people chasing nickels and dimes.
So right now, the third number column in Article 2 says fiscal year 2018 rec, and that is meant to be recommended by both the Finance Committee and the Select Board.
Is it?
So recommended.
That's this.
And as I'm sure you know, we always try to get consensus between the Finance Committee and the Select Board before we go to town meeting. There are some towns that don't bother to do that, and their town meetings last a lot longer than ours and are a lot less fun.
Yes, you're right there.
Are there any fights?
All right, you want to run through the finance questions?
Yeah, I've got to put the boilerplate recommendation under Article 3.
Yep.
Article 3 is a vote to borrow money for design and engineering. I have included the $1,100 cost of borrowing that money under debt service, 751 in Article 2. So there are two ways to do it. I could have included that money in Article 3. The treasurer's preference was to have it under debt service in Article 2. It is an operational cost. This will be a two-thirds vote. It's to see whether or not the town will vote to borrow $130,000. The intent is to protect the village center from decay as people have to spend more and more on their septic systems, and people might not want to buy their houses for the extra $30,000. Housing prices in Conway are high. This was intended to protect the downtown, and you may remember that the planning board came out with a village center zoning proposal a couple of years ago, and that was to encourage mixed-use development downtown, more commercial, give people more flexibility in what they could do with their property if they were making for a more commercially vibrant downtown. And a lot of people said, you're putting the cart before the horse. We can't fit any more people downtown because the septic's a limitation. So fix that first. They spun off the wastewater committee. The Wastewater Committee is now bringing this forward to see whether the town wants to actually do that. The town very well may not, but that's what this article's about.
So is this not a money article because we approved the money in Article 2?
No, this is a money article.
But then it doesn't need our recommendation, or?
Yes, it does.
Just left that out.
I'll put the boilerplate recommendation in.
So if Article 3 doesn't pass, then $1,100 will be towards free cash the following year?
I
would think so.
Maybe we can pay off $1,100 more of the principal of some loan we have due.
Just curious.
We will have $1,100 extra dollars in the budget. Yeah. Yes.
It's a real deal breaker.
I think it's important also to note that the language of Article 3 states that this, if this were approved, it would be contingent on a vote to debt exclude it.
Yes.
A ballot that would be on the election.
Yes.
So
it would be a temporary
little sentence at the very end here, but that means that this would not go towards our 2.5 limit. It might be excluded from that calculation.
Yeah, so it takes a 2/3 vote at town meeting and a majority vote at the ballot box afterwards.
This is a steep mountain to climb, wouldn't you say?
Yes, it is.
This is only the beginning.
Yes.
Yeah, that's the thing.
For 30 homes.
Yes.
Yeah. Well,
I'll just remind the Finance Committee, it is entirely possible on any of these not to have a recommendation. And presumably you won't have a recommendation on non-money articles. I don't see actually the need to include that line here if you don't have a recommendation. For the Board of Selectmen, I'll include it for all of the warrant articles because it's the Select Board's warrant. But for you, I don't think you need it. I don't think I have it in some of the planning board articles.
We did take a vote on this.
Okay.
It was 0-4, not recommended at this time.
Recommended, okay.
At this time was part of it, meaning...
We just heard from the schools.
Well, yeah, meaning, you know, this is, and not just that.
Did you want to vote again, or is that still...
No, I think that there's an just like anything, there's an education process that has to happen here. Now, it's possible an argument could be made that if you make that downtown more appealing and people put retail businesses on the first floor of their houses, granted there'll be parking issues maybe or whatever, but maybe there's an argument to be made that the increased tax revenue will make this a sort of neutral thing. But that takes us, you know, pretty sophisticated modeling, I think, to do that.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think that this we're between a rock and a hard place.
All right. So
we need wired waste.
So the Finance Committee's recommendation on this article is not to recommend it. Okay.
This article, you can
at this town meeting. At this time.
Not to recommend. Okay. Discussion on the board?
I think we should do it. But, you know...
This has to be the first step in whatever we do with the downtown. Because it can be... Nothing can be done without this step.
I watched what Ashfield went through, trying to put through their wastewater treatment for their town. Yes. And this is so much... cheaper, a very different approach. I think it's the right approach.
A couple of things. I think, and this will be brought out in any presentation at town meeting, I think it's the intent of this, of whatever the system is, to pay back the town through user fees over a period of time. But we can check with the Wastewater Committee on that. The other thing is, there have been two people who have been working on this. One of them is moving out of town this year, and it may not go forward again if it doesn't go forward now. But and that's not meant to, you know, sway the. And I just want to be clear that it is a negative recommendation and not a lack of a recommendation. So it is a no. Right? That's
nope.
Okay.
Okay.
Just wanted to be clear on that.
All right. I agree with Bob that I think this is important if we're going to go forward in any way with the center of town. Bob, do you have any comments?
I totally disagree with that. Stand with the Finance Committee on this one.
Okay.
What?
I'll make a motion that we recommend the article. We have a yay vote, a no vote, and a yay vote.
Bob, so Bob 2-1. Armstrong would second that as the...
Yeah, I'll second it. Yep.
Second.
Thank you.
And it's a 2-1-4. Okay.
Yeah. What happens, so the $130,000 for design and engineering, what's the projected cost?
They don't even know.
That's why you do the design and engineering. The purpose is to get a cost of the project so they know how much it is and whether to bring that to town meeting.
Cost $130,000 to find out what it might cost.
It's amazing.
The way
to think.
The way I look at this is we're spending $130,000 on how many different engineering projects in the town of Conway, and our infrastructure buildings are crumbling. Yep. Where do we start first? I think we need to start with the buildings.
Okay.
With what we already have.
For town meetings for.
Yeah, town meeting floor, that's right.
It'll be interesting.
Right? Hey, maybe they won't like it, they won't like me next year, if I rerun.
No.
No.
No, you know, this is...
I don't think we have to agree on every...
You know,
this is something that you could be on either side of and be right.
Yeah.
Well, this is also something that could pass town meeting and not make it through the ballot.
Yeah, that's true, too.
That's right.
Yeah, you know, this...
A lot of options.
This is a big step.
In a way that can fail.
More people go to vote than go to town meeting.
Yes.
Unfortunately.
Tom, you want to go to the next article?
Article 4 is asking for $100,000 for the highway garage stabilization account. I would direct your attention to the sources and uses sheet you should have. The intent is to have this money come from free cash. This $100,000 will be the first time, if it goes in, that we exceed the amount of money that we had when we started the project last time. So after, if this goes through, we will have a little bit more money than we had before. So it'll basically be the same place. I think it's an extra $25,000. We'll be about where we were before if this passes.
What's your recommendation on that?
4-0, recommended.
Recommended, okay. Any comments on the board? Are we in favor?
I'm in favor.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we recommend this article.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, 3-1. 3-0. Tom, next one.
Article 5 is a non-money article. I'd be happy to take the Finance Committee recommendation out or say no recommendation, but I think it's clearer if I just leave it out.
Okay.
This was suggested by Robert Baker.
I asked to have that put on, because I've got a lot of town citizens comment to me that it's time we move forward to highway garage again.
And there are
a non-binding question.
There are a couple of changes in town, including getting broadband, that will that I think are will help in having it pass this time. Article 6.
Wait, I got a question about Article 5. So it takes a two-thirds vote, right, to approve the borrowing.
Right.
How is there a way that we can have this decision on the town floor? Of course, that we can gauge how close to two-thirds this will be. Because, I mean, if we just say, yay, yay, you know, we have to do a hand count, right?
Yeah, that's basically what this will do, is judge the sentiment of the town to go forward next year.
Right, but can we ask the moderator to do a hand count on this one?
You explain to him what you want.
We'll go to town meeting.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I'll ask Nick about that and see whether he would prefer to have that stated in the article, because there may be conditions in which he can and can't ask for a...
Right.
I'll check with him.
I want to know, it's just like, yeah, you know, there's voices. I can't really tell. Is that just barely a majority, or is that like...
Right.
Close to two-thirds already? Like, what's our...
You keep losing by a few votes.
We want an exact count.
Yeah,
that's fine.
Yeah. And of course, different people will show up in next year's meeting, but whatever, yeah.
Article 6 is funding capital stabilization. I have a different funding mix to propose. It's in the sources and uses sheet. It involves free cash, general stabilization, and... raising and appropriating $75,000. The reason I'm suggesting raising and appropriating on this is because I think it's one of the most important things on the warrant. And I think if we give people a choice to raise and appropriate for something rather than take it from free cash, some people might think, if I have to raise and appropriate for this, I'm not gonna do it. But if it's this important an article, I think people would be more likely to vote to raise and appropriate the 75 and
work with the free cash and general stabilization the other way. I don't think getting money from general stabilization and putting into capital stabilization is a long-term solution. It's certainly not sustainable. I'm not proposing anything for general stabilization this year, because as we were working through the budget, it became more and more difficult. And although we do have some excess levy capacity at this time, general stabilization now has $400,000 in it. It's not hurting. Capital stabilization is, if you take out the $285,000 that we've dedicated to the fire truck, we have less than $200,000 in it, substantially less than $200,000. So I think we need to get it up. This is my proposal for the funding mix.
What's your recommendation?
Didn't we? No, we didn't vote on this.
Do you want to have this whole thing raised appropriate?
No. It's
well, you want to fix like it's on the piece of paper.
Yeah, I do want to change the amount to $125,000. Yeah, you should have that.
Oh, okay, there is.
Yeah.
Okay.
The amount should be $125,000. That's fully funding it.
So we take out the $95,000 that you have in the ARP.
Yeah. The 125 in the brackets is correct, yep. But the mix was not. That was an alternative.
It would be 125 here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
75, 21, and 29.
Yep. And that's to avoid, we're right at the edge of using our free cash. We have less than $1,000 left in free cash.
What's your recommendation on that?
No, I've got a side conversation going.
Could you control your committee, please?
Sorry. We're all volunteers.
Sorry.
Anarchy happening over here. So we're looking for, I guess, a recommendation for the, if you look at the sources and uses sheet on the back of the handout tonight, right. Do you have that? It's the short paper. It's the very last page of the warrant on the warrant. So if you go to the back of the warrant, there's like a little letter-sized piece stuck at the back. It's called sources and uses. You see that?
Yep.
And then number six there is Tom's proposed source of funding to come up with $125,000 for the capital stabilization account.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah.
So what is, where is the capital's, where is that account right now, capital stabilization?
I think it's as low as 125,000. It's either 125 or 175. I was hedging a little bit earlier, but it had been at 400,000. Well, let's see, we took out 285, so it's right now it's about
15.
Well, we've gotten interest, and there it's all approximate there. So,
and where's the garage stabilization without this 100,000 here?
It's somewhere about 700, a little over 700,000.
So we are marching inexorably towards a garage. And what was the cost of the last garage that was voted down?
Which cost?
Which cost? Yeah.
What was the total project cost?
I think it was 2.1.
2.1.
Yeah.
So yeah, the borrowing was just under $2 million.
Okay.
Right.
I took one of the side conversation was I looked down at the very bottom of the sheet at a 20.72 tax rate estimated, and Tom actually showed me the paper was quoting 19.something.
Yeah, this is a new calculation, and it is with the most conservative figures that are available to us now. You'll note that it's 2017 valuation. We don't know what the new growth is going to be. We don't know what our cherry sheet's going to be. We don't know. Our town revenue usually comes in above what it's going to be. So that is.
What's this year's tax rate?
I always hesitate. It's 1775.
My bet is that it will come down much closer to what I had in my budget. But,
I mean,
worst case scenario.
That's staggering.
That's the worst case. Now, and I'll also point out that the current proposal, with all those little figures, actually is less of a dollar increase from this year to next year than we had from last year to this year.
What's the dollar amount?
The dollar amount is actually a little tiny bit less.
Yeah, because we were 16 something the year before.
Well, you have 17.75.
We have to spend how much to create a dollar on the tax rate?
I don't have that offhand. Lee is the person I go to for that.
You're talking about a $3? You're talking about a $3 increase?
It's like $90,000 last year or something?
It all depends on the current valuation of the property. There's all kinds of variables that we won't know until next year. We won't have the tax rate for next year set until the fall, or late summer.
What do you consider, maybe not wanting to approve this simply to try to keep the tax rate down?
No, I'm just trying to understand in my own brain, because I'm just a taxpayer like everybody else, and I got to remind myself that A, the federal taxes haven't gone up, and the state taxes haven't gone up, the income taxes. Maybe some of the fees have gone up or whatever. So in the end, it comes to out right here. It's like it's going through this funnel, and this is where.
Well, we've told everybody that we need to tighten our belts about as tight as we can. Maybe we should consider lowering that down.
Well, what I'm saying, Bob.
Keep it tighter, yeah. Keep the tax rate down even more.
In my mind, okay, whether or not you put $100,000 into the garage, for example. To me, it's neither here nor there, because in the end, you're going to be borrowing.
Right.
You're going to borrow $2 million, $2.1, $1.9, whatever it is, over 30 years or so.
Probably 20.
If that is going to offer any kind of relief, but the amount of relief it's going to offer is not a lot anyway.
Peanuts.
I look at this $3. This is staggering. Tom, you can't tell me we went up $3 between... between 2015 and 2016?
No, and I'm saying we're probably not going to go up $3 between this year and next year.
I would hope not.
You were below 10.
That's based on this year's valuations with a very conservative new growth estimate, with a conservative local aid estimate, with conservative local receipt estimates. There's a whole lot of things that are going to bring that number down, but you should know that that's what the number is.
If you use,
if valuations don't go up, if we don't get any more money from anything, in a worst case scenario,
could we consider doing a trade off, saying if we keep on raising up the garage fund, and then do a trade off between in terms of the impact on property tax rates of borrowing versus continuing to do this type of strategy, to find out what's the best. In terms of property tax rate increases, how it impacts that. In other words, trying to trade off between to what point we build up the equity, so to speak, in the project versus the trade off of then borrowing to finance the rest.
My recommendation up till now has been to increase the stabilization fund at least $400,000 or $500,000 more than we had it last time, mm-hmm. in order to lower the cost of the amount of borrowing. Mm-hmm. We have a select board member who's anxious to push ahead, mm-hmm. and thinks that the town will act is ready to vote for it now. Mm-hmm. Right. If they are, that's fine. We get it sooner. Mm-hmm. We get more of our problems solved sooner, right. Rather than, we fund it later rather than funding it now. It's going to be the same amount of money. Do we wait until we have that much more money in stabilization, or do we get what we need now? The last time, a lot of people thought that the cost of the borrowing was too high. And that's why I took as one of my guiding principles that we should lower the cost of the borrowing before going ahead. But if the sentiment is otherwise, I'm happy to go ahead. I was happy to go ahead before.
For next year, what do you think the tax rate increase will be? I mean, you have 20.7 as an estimate. As a conservative estimate.
Yeah.
But
There's no way to say that.
I've taken a stab at this for a few years, trying to come up with I mean, you're basically trying to recreate the recap in May, in March or whatever, right. You know?
Yeah,
and it's, and you can't, you don't know the numbers.
Yeah.
So what you're doing is you're saying, okay, new growth is going to be this. Overlay maybe will be this. You know, we're going to estimate with the cherry sheets, you know, which version of the cherry sheet do we, you know, I mean, there's... Mm-hmm. There's all these variables, and I think to his point, you know, which valuation do you use, right? And so you can do your own calculation. I mean, I've tried it. I didn't try it this year. I think we're paying the town administrator to make that those to plug those numbers in.
What's
now,
your recommendation on Article 6?
So guys, do you see the mix of funds for this? There's three different. He's actually proposing we pull some from general stabilization, raise and appropriate $75,000, and then take a piece from free cash. I think it's a good mix. I like the idea that we keep funding it at the $125,000. That was what the grid showed. I would move that we recommend that this grouping, whatever sources. All right, all in favor?
Aye.
You got four to zero there?
I guess so, yeah.
Okay. So well, I heard a second, so I assume that's an aye. So.
Yeah, do we
have any discussion on the board?
I support it.
I'm a little concerned about draining that. Tom says if this gets approved, we're only going to have like $1,000 left in free cash?
Well,
man, that's cutting that way down.
How much in free cash?
It'll only be about $1,000 left, Tom said.
That's fine.
$1,000? Oh, yeah.
I'll make a motion that we recommend.
For years we rolled free cash forward and that didn't.
Do we have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. 3-0 on recommendation by the board. Article 7.
Conway Grammar School capital stabilization, the same $50,000 as it's been for several years.
Okay. What's your recommendation, Finance?
4-0. Recommend.
4-0. Okay. Board?
I'm good.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we approve Article 7. Do I have a second?
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
3-0. Okay, next article.
We have received requests for a number of different projects for capital expenses for the Conway Grammar School. They total $35,000. This would come from the Conway Grammar School capital stabilization account.
All right, so we're just giving them permission to take money out of their own account.
It's not going
to
hit the tax rate, huh?
No.
2/3 vote.
So, yes, so it'll require...
You've got to have that in parentheses there, Tom.
Right.
Yeah, that's why I said it.
Mm. So we're putting 50 in, and they're going to take 35 out?
Yep.
Yep.
What is their projected project stay under? We haven't seen that anywhere, right?
Well, we signed...
I do
warrant kind of articles a while ago for this kind of project. I think part of it was to go to the baseball game. I can't remember. There was a bunch of individual small projects that we funded.
And the stabilization account?
Well, they'll be funded for out of this kind of an account. Well, these are capital expenses, so no, these are different.
Yeah, that's different.
I want the installation of security cameras at front and rear entrances for $2,500. Replace the air conditioning unit in the library for $5,000. Purchase of a new floor machine for $1,000. Repair the exterior door frames for $2,500. Upgrade the floor finishes in one classroom for $4,000. Installation of hand dryers in all bathrooms, $5,000. Upgrade the clock.
How many bathrooms do we have?
Quite a few. What do we got?
This is Conway Grammar School, right? 5,000 for hand dryers?
Well, don't forget to think of the blah blah. It's going to be wiring costs because there's no wiring in there for them. Think about electric hand dryers. In. The dryers are about $100 a piece.
Yeah, and it costs $2,000 to put them in. Right?
I know, I just bought them. $99! Of course, that won't be good enough for the school. That'll be more money than that.
Sure.
And finally, the largest request is to upgrade their clock and intercom system, which is a $15,000
item. Didn't we just do that? couple of years ago?
Yes, when we renovated the building last.
When was that?
Well, Maureen Chase and them were on it. That's about 4 years ago?
No, it's
more than four.
Was it more? Probably was.
It's got to be, six or 7 years ago.
I don't know.
Whatever.
We spent money on the phone system up there.
Yes, we did.
Right? I don't know if the clock and intercom is the same system.
All right.
Would we touch that recently?
What's your recommendation?
Well, we have to vote because we didn't understand what it was, but now that we understand it.
I think they should use it for the health care.
I don't disagree. I don't disagree at all.
Well, I mean, we've been putting the money into the stabilization account. This would be the first withdrawal, I think, from the stabilization account.
When was the last time there was a withdrawal from the stabilization?
What's the balance?
What's the balance? When was the last time we took money?
I think it's $150,000.
When was the last time we took money out to pay for it?
No, we haven't.
I don't think
we
ever have.
This would be the first withdrawal. We were putting the money in there because there was a list of things, and these are... I don't know if these were on the original list, but you know the big ones are the like the boiler.
The boiler. Yeah.
That's still the case, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, what has to get done? Security cameras. Sounds like we have much of an option there, right? That's being recommended by the police.
Mm-hmm. The hand dryers are there, I know, because they don't like using paper towels in the school. Whatever that is. Anytime I've been there, there's been. 2 towels in
the That's a very expensive item. It really is. Over the course of a year.
Paper towels.
Sure. Well, yeah, so that's why they're in there. So do we hear a motion to move to
I'll accept? I move we recommend Article 8.
Second.
Finance Committee.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
There we go. 4-0.
Okay. Questions on the board?
I'm with them.
Okay. I'll make a motion that we accept Article 8. All in favor? Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. 3-0. Article 9.
This, remember Ron coming in and talking about this. The main question that people had was, well, shouldn't you just rent it instead of buying it? And his... he feels that he has a lot of work that he can do with it. He can do a lot more of the roadside trimming that he needs to do with this. And it would be impractical to rent basically a unit for the whole summer. Also, this is not just, it is for the highway department, but it's for both the highway and the building maintenance functions. We will be able to do work higher up on buildings if we have a lift.
Mm-hmm. What if you brought Article 10? What happened to 9?
Article 9.
We're on 9.
Article 9.
Hydraulic coolant.
Yeah.
How come mine says Article 10?
You have an old one, do you?
Get the old one. This. I was looking at the old one too.
Okay. So 29, so what happened to Article 9? Is that?
The $29,000 from Frontier has been removed from our consideration. The Frontier School Committee did not take a vote on it.
Okay.
And I just got a note from the superintendent saying, so we won't be making that request. There are a number of different tiers of options that they have for fixing the problem. They believe they can solve the immediate problem with available funds.
Okay. Sorry.
Any other discussion on 9?
We recommend it. 4-0.
Okay. Any discussion on the board?
I do.
Okay.
I think it's a huge liability issue for the town of Conway. Absolutely huge. Because you're going to have a guy up in the air on a platform. Most all your roads, quite a few of the places, have electricity wires on one side or the other. One mistake by that operator up in that boom truck, we're going to be paying a lot of money.
Well, what do we do? What do we do now?
We hire companies to do it. That are insured and to do that, and that's the way it should be left.
I don't think we considered that aspect when we voted.
And then, on top of that, it was mentioned that we can use it on town buildings to do repairs. Who's going to go up there and do it? Really? Who's going to get up there and do it on the lift?
Waitley seems to have one of these.
Is your highway department going to send a guy up there to work on a building? No. So who are we going to send, a janitor up there?
Are they just, is this here because they want to be like Waitley? I mean...
I don't know. I'm totally, totally not in favor of this. That's all I'm going to say.
Bob, they still have the chopper that's on the hydraulic arm over the edge?
Yep.
That we bought, right?
We own one now.
We did at one point share it, kind of around, and then...
Right, we own it now.
So that's not adequate?
No, that wouldn't do this.
No, this lifts up to do trimming higher up.
Ron's argument is the trees have gotten taller, and yes, the power company maybe takes care of the side with the wires, but they don't take care of the side without the wires. And so... Is there liability
to do that instead of hiring it out?
Is there liability should a tree fall and somebody hit the tree in their car? What kind of liability is that?
Is for a cherry picker on a truck versus one of those?
We've been covering the issues for the last 100 years by hiring a tree company to take care of it. Yeah. What is wrong with that?
I was wondering, did they, any numbers run to make a comparison?
Yeah. Is this totally for trees?
Trees and building
maintenance.
He said it would also be available for building maintenance activities. There was an issue where we have apparently a tree growing out of the chimney in this.
Yes, we do. We absolutely do.
So that would be
watching it from my house. Yeah.
And the other thing is, and the third thing I'll say about it: where are you going to store this thing?
Is this a cherry picker on the garage?
I think it's a trailer.
It's a cherry picker on the back of a pickup truck, I think, is what it is.
Right? I don't think so.
No?
It's a trailer type, I think.
It's a trailer.
Okay. In the sheet by the garage.
So wait, is this one of the ones that, like, it's got the four wheels and it drives real slow-like and it has a... Is it one of those kind of things?
I don't know if it's got an engine on it, or are you going to supply the title?
So do we want to revote here?
Sure.
I vote, I make a motion to no recommendation on this.
Second.
So finance is voting no recommendation, is that?
No, let him make his case in front of the town meeting.
No, not an unrecommended, no position.
Yeah. Right.
Like,
totally
so
confused.
So where you would like just take our name off of it.
Right.
Right, no recommendation.
Right.
Okay. All right, well, based on Bob's concerns here, I would suggest a no recommendation from the Board of Selectmen as well.
I agree.
All right.
Okay.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Yeah. Aye.
Okay. And then the case can be made on town floor.
Since this is a money article, I would prefer to put that you actively did not make a recommendation.
So, yeah.
I'm with you guys. No recommendation.
No recommendation.
Article 10.
Not recommended, but no recommendation.
Tom. This is
yeah. Article 10. I fought a hard battle with the Capital Improvements Planning Committee recommendation, and they beat me back from paving to hardtack. We need to straighten out the parking lot in the back of the town office. It's very uneven. It's unsafe, especially in the winter. We need to make it a smooth level surface.
What's your recommendation?
3-1 recommended.
3-1. Okay, Finance Committee's 3-1 recommendation. Do we have any discussion on the board?
I'm for it.
Okay.
I park there.
Okay.
I'll say my recommendation is, if I was in the position I was in before, it just would have gotten done. And so there's a highway budget.
So it's going to be done by the highway crew. Yeah, it's just a question of
what they said.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll make a recommendation that we approve this article. Do I have a second?
Second.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Bob?
You abstain.
Okay. We have 2-0 and 1 abstention. Okay. Article 11.
This is the state is changing its computer system. The town has a variety of options They've looked at a number of them, and the assessors are proposing this particular one, which is a $2,500 cost.
Not a two-thirds vote.
4-0, we recommend.
Why is it 2/3?
Huh?
Tom?
We recommended 4-0.
He said 3-1, you said 4-0.
No, on this one here?
Remember, the numbers are different now.
No, I'm on article.
Well, you're looking at
the software.
Yeah.
2,500.
Yes.
Right?
4-0, assessor's software.
That's what I wrote. We recommend.
3-1?
Yeah, that's what I have here. No, that was the one above it.
Oh, all right.
3-1 or 4-0?
For you, it's article 12, right?
4-0 on the, yeah, we can't on the 2,500 conversion.
4-0, okay.
We need to vote again, once and for all, to make it clear.
Yeah. So I move to accept the article, is it 11?
11.
11, 2,500, okay. All in favor?
Aye.
There you go.
4-0. We have any discussion on the board here? I'll make a motion that we approve this article. Second, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay, 3-0. 12.
This is a repurposing article. We had originally appropriated some money to re-roof the central office. They've since moved out of that facility, and they would like to use the funds instead for their relocation. They've already done the relocation, but this would, within the fiscal year, this will help with those costs.
We voted 4-0.
4-0, okay.
Thanks.
And we voted 3-0.
Yep.
All right. Next.
We need to come up with a number for this, or just delete it. You may remember last year you took a lot of money out of ambulance receipts reserved to apply to the operating budget. And so after we take out the amount from receipts reserved below for $32,153, we have something less than, I think, $3,000 left in receipts reserved. So we may just not want to do anything. The ambulance stabilization fund has $150,000 in it. The $3,000 can stay in receipts reserved until next year when there's a larger pile. In fact, I might recommend that in case receipts reserve comes in a little bit low and we have to fund their operations. So I would actually recommend striking this from the warrant.
13.
Yes.
Yeah.
13. That makes sense.
We didn't vote anyway.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. Let's strike it. I have 14.
I thought we already did.
Yeah, we already did.
Yeah. This was our 153, right?
Yeah.
The so for the operating expenses for the ambulance department, which will come from ambulance receipts reserved, the current number, 32,153, represents last year's number, plus the increase for this year, plus an increase in radio fees that we didn't know about before, about $1,100. So that's the intent of this article.
4-0, recommend.
Okay. Any discussion by the board?
No.
Okay.
So
I'll make a motion that would recommend this article.
So that's that plus the 15,000 that we're voting on. Article 2, right?
Yes.
Total, gives their total budget.
Yes.
Yeah, as we do every year with them.
Okay.
Article 15.
What, we just did?
We didn't vote. We approved the motion, but not the vote.
Oh.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Go ahead, 15.
For the recertification of property values, this used to be the article that was for revaluation, for a triennial revaluation. Now it's on a 5-year cycle. This was part of the Municipal Modernization Act. There were some changes to the way things are done. We can do a 5-year cycle. We have to update it every year anyway. So instead of 7,000 every 3 years, we're going to try 5,000 every year for 5 years. That's what this is.
We voted on it, didn't we?
So that's an increase of $4,000 over 5 years. No, I'm sorry, $21,000 in 3 years.
It's taken the increase into consideration.
Well, it's five,
We voted 4-0.
Okay.
Recommended.
Any discussion on that?
No.
All right, I'll make a motion that we approve this article. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. 16.
Local library operations and expenses, that is the closest number we have to what's on the cherry sheet, which is our obligation to pay the library to continue its accreditation.
We recommend 4-0.
Okay, any discussion on that?
No.
Okay, I'll make a motion that we approve this article.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. 17.
To pay a town clerk bill from a previous fiscal year. The state used to pay for a service. They didn't. She wasn't expecting it. She's left with a bill for $90.85. I would recommend authorizing $91.
Okay.
We recommend it's 4-0.
Okay. Any discussion by the board? Yeah. Okay. I'll recommend we approve this article.
One of our harder votes.
All in favor?
We submitted
it. Okay.
Now we come to an interesting discussion. I had put a placeholder on the warrant about work related to the tornado of February 25th, 2017. Current estimates are overtime is about $25,000. We have some immediate work to do behind the Conway Grammar School where the trail has been blocked by fallen trees. So there's a patch of fallen trees there, relatively small. Deeper in, the trail is also blocked by a number of fallen trees. I'm considering that at this point kind of a separate operation. We're gonna need some assessment of that. It's in endangered species habitat. Probably if we just cleared the trail, we would be able to do it for relatively inexpensively. If we got a recommendation from a forester that some of the wood should be removed, it would become a more involved operation. So I don't really have any numbers for what that might cost now, but there will probably be a range of options. Right now, though, we can easily clear the front part for under $10,000, probably under $5,000. That said, we have enough money currently in our reserve fund to fund the town expenses related to the tornado. Obviously not residential expenses. And so I would ask the finance committee to consider the possibility of using reserve fund monies for funding the overtime and initial tree clearing.
What's in the reserve fund?
Related to the tornado, I'm sorry.
What's in the reserve fund?
About $35,000 now. I mean, we've been asked by the state to come up with numbers as to, you know, what it's going to be. They're going to look at the numbers and think that it's pocket change.
Yep.
Yeah. It doesn't necessarily mean that we shouldn't ask for it, but given that we're able to, we have the money right now. If we don't have any more emergencies before June 30th, it makes sense to me not to use our powder on this one, and not to ask the state for this amount of help when it is conceivable that we could fund it ourselves. We may need more money at some point in the future, and we don't want to establish a reputation of, you know, being greedy.
All right, what are we going to do? Strike this article?
If the state turns this down, that means we'd have to have a special?
No.
To take it out of the reserve fund?
No, you can just, he'll just submit a request to us.
It's really a question.
So that's what your guys control.
Right.
Yeah. That's what the fund was for. One of the,
I recommend it. The select board have the article strike.
Yeah. We don't need it, right?
Yeah.
What you said, provided we don't have some weird emergency between now and the end of June.
Exactly.
What happens if that happens?
You know.
Who knows? Back to the drawing board.
Well, if it's a bona fide emergency, we do what we did this time, and we ask the state for the permission to have deficit spending, and they grant it, and everything's legal.
All right, I'll make a motion that we strike Article 18.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
And Article 19.
I will submit that reserve fund transfer proposal.
Okay.
This is all internal Concom stuff. You don't have anything to do with that. These are all according to various regulations and stipulations. Finance committee has nothing to do with this.
With what they want to spend it on.
With what they want to spend it on, how much more buckets they have to allocate, and that's all a Concom.
Article 19, what's your recommendation on it?
As community preservation. I have taken out a section on wastewater design and engineering. Our accountant was uncomfortable with that being straying a bit far from the purposes of community preservation. She checked with the Department of Revenue, who agreed with her assessment, so we decided to go ahead with this for borrowing instead of through community preservation.
We didn't vote on A through C. We voted on section D.
I don't think finance committee makes a recommendation on Concom's thing. This is a totally internal. I know you guys voted on it. Well, I wasn't there, but I don't think we've made any recommendation.
Just scratch your recommendation out totally then.
Unless you guys feel strongly about getting on the record on this one, this is not our bailiwick.
Okay, just take you got your finance money out.
You should probably go to rescind your previous vote.
So I would move that we revote, that we make no recommendation at all for the Concom article.
Second.
Or not Concom, but Prescom. What is this?
Community
Preservation.
Second.
Article 19.
All in favor?
No recommendation?
Yeah.
All right, good.
All right, I'll make a motion that we do not make a recommendation on this article. Do I have a second?
A second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.
Next article is another repurposing. We have $7,788.98 remaining from a previous article for engineering and permitting for improvements to the town ball field. We would like to use that money for other improvements to the town field area. It's related to the original purpose, which we think is a good thing, but it's much broader. And this could be used for soil for the infield. If there's money left over, maybe partially working on, hey, if we get problems with the tennis court and basketball half courts there, which we know are pooling a little bit of water. So that's the intent of this.
What's your recommendation?
4-0.
Okay. All right, I'll make a motion that we approve this article. Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
So this is basically a non-money article, though.
Right. Yeah, basically.
It was just repurposing.
Yeah.
Do we have any other money articles?
We have a right to farm and 3 planning board articles. I assume you don't even wish to be mentioned in relation to these.
Didn't the town do a right to farm a couple of years ago?
It wasn't passed. It was brought up, but it wasn't passed at town meeting.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What was the problem, you remember, John?
It would seem to be too restrictive, and this has been eased quite a bit, this one. Yeah, I guess that's it.
Yeah, and then there are a couple of resolutions at the end that are also not.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Gentlemen, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Jim, I thought you weren't going to be here. So.
So we don't have to
miss it. Unless it needs help proofing it,
right?
For a good sign.
Yeah.
Good job.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen, for all your hard work.
Yep.
Thank you. Okay, have a good night. All right, we've done just about everything else on the agenda. The next meeting is scheduled for next Monday, April the 3rd, at the town offices.
What time?
At 6 o'clock.
Okay.
Any other business to come before the board? I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second it.
Thank you. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay.